It's been banned from paint in this country for more than 4 decades, but now a new pair of studies show the impact of lead is still being felt right here in Cleveland, and those reports make it quite clear who is suffering most from lead poisoning.
It's our kids, and the problem is hitting certain areas harder than others. News 5's Jordan Vandenberg live tonight to break it down for us. Jordan.
Well, one of the key points in this study is that these studies show that the results of this lead exposure is not only affecting children's performance in the classroom, but also potentially the trajectory of their life. Children are society's greatest resource, but in Cleveland, they're at a greater risk of being exposed to a scourge banned 40 years ago.
If you look at the school level, some schools, their kindergarten cohorts have a third to nearly a half of their kindergartners have a lead history.
Dr. Rob Fisher and his team at Case Western Reserve spent months sifting through health and education data. The team's two studies released Monday show that a staggering 25% of CMSD kindergartners have tested positive for high levels of lead at least once before age 6. Lead exposure was especially prevalent for students at two Eastside schools, Iowa Maple and Franklin D. Roosevelt, where nearly half of those tested had elevated levels.
If you think about the implications of lead, both cognitively and behaviorally, it has implications for how well that child is going to do in classroom settings. And those needs need to be managed.
Lead is a neurotoxin that can affect a child's cognitive abilities. And exposure comes from lead-based paint that's present on much of the city's aging housing stock. Dr. Fisher's research shows those who were exposed to it are half as likely to be on track with their peers on kindergarten academic assessments. The studies also highlight children on the east side are far more likely to be exposed.
As somebody who's been looking at poverty in Cleveland the last couple decades, it's not surprising to me because we knew that it was co-occurring with poverty, and we know the landscape of poverty in the city of Cleveland.
The studies also highlighted the need for more children to undergo testing by their first and second birthdays, as is required for those on Medicaid. As staggering and as sobering as this new data may be, Dr. Fisher hopes it finally prompts multidimensional change from public, private, and philanthropic entities.
Our big goal is to put the right kind of data in front of partners who have the juice and the energy to carry out something that makes a big difference here.
Dr. Fisher says the next phase of this assessment will be even more comprehensive, studying these kids all the way through school and into early adulthood. Reporting live downtown, Jordan Vandenberg, News 5.